In this video, I should be reviewing the red hot core workout as part of the DDP beginners yoga program. I will also be sharing what I discovered after I visited a local sports therapist. My name's Serge, and I'm trying to lose weight. Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. Week 16 of my weight loss journey. However, week 11 on the DDP beginners yoga program, and that is because injuries. This week, the structure remains the same, whereby it's a Monday, Wednesday, and a Friday workout. Monday, we've got the below the belt workout. Wednesday, it's a double energy workout. And then Friday, we have a fat burn and red hot core workout. However, similar to the last few weeks, rather than do a double workout in a day, I've done one workout every single day on my lunch because it makes life easier. However, I will also share, because I've had this niggling pain for the last few weeks, I did go and visit a sports therapist and made a little discoveries of my own, and I will cover that after the workout. So this week, we're gonna do the red hot core workout. And once again, I'll mention some of the changes I've made this week. So in 3, 2, 1, let go. Okay, ladies and gentlemen. You know what it is. In week 16 of my weight loss program, going into week 11 on the DDP yoga program. Going straight into the red hot core this week. You know how it is? We go straight into the warm up. Going into the ab crunches here. See how it's all a little bit more controlled this week. The focus is on control. But don't get me wrong, belly still gets in the way, but we are working on that. Scissoring that bad boy up, however, whilst I have progressed in terms of the modification on the scissors, you can still see that my legs are still a little bit bent, meaning calves and hamstrings are still a little tight. So this stretch here, I'll get to the point where I can stretch my legs out because the hamstrings and calf would be more mobile. But let's get straight into the ab workout that really does get me. Right, we're 10 seconds in almost, and not ab pull to be seen as of yet. I think what I do need to do during these ab workouts is focus on the breathing a little bit as well. Okay, in the past, you know, I couldn't do this little table, inverted table position, but look guys and gals, I'm slowly getting there. I mean, don't get me wrong, I didn't achieve it this time around, but I'm getting there. Ah, there we go. Pulled an arm muscle today. This one actually hurt. This one actually really did hurt. If you can see my face, look at my face, this one actually hurt. So rather than pulling the abs this time around, we pulled, I don't know, is that a tricep muscle? I think it was a tricep muscle. Oh, either way it hurt. I literally had to pause the workout for this. Right, so whilst I do this stretch, I don't know what it is. I don't think I pulled, did I pull a muscle here? No, I don't know what it was, but I was actually, there was a lot of pain there. I'm not sure what that was. I'm not dying, I'm just in a lot of pain here. Hip flexor, that's what it was. Hip flexor, yes. Lunchtime workouts are the best because that's when I have the most energy. See here, last time I recorded the red hot core workout, I couldn't get on all fours and do that full crunch, but we got there this time round. Upside down broken table crunch. So last time I noticed myself bending my arms as I got to the top, so the focus here was trying to keep my arms and legs as straight as possible alternatively. So better control here. We're getting there slowly, guys. We're getting there slowly. And that's it for this week. So red hot core, the first few times pulling a few muscles, this time, not too bad. I'm getting better. Let's go straight into the diet firstly. Diet this week, once again, we've been all right. If you look on the screen now, I'm at 13.3 stone, which one of two things actually, either my scales are broken or I've not changed any weight in the last 2 weeks. Because as I'm getting stronger, it may just be muscle weight. As I mentioned at the very beginning of this video, I went to visit a sports therapist this week just because my legs were feeling a little bit tighter, a little bit worn, and I was pulling muscles more in my legs this week, so I thought I needed to go and get a sports massage done. However, what a discovery this was. Well, I say discovery, it's nothing I wasn't aware of, but I wasn't educated enough on it. In the past, I've mentioned to yourself, I've had injuries in my back, in my legs, in my shoulder, and what this yoga has done over the last few weeks is increase my flexibility and increase my mobility. However, with that, because the muscles are now becoming looser, and those muscles that have been protecting injuries in the past because they've been fixed and tight around that injury, I'm now discovering more injuries underneath. Which, now I'm thinking to myself, was there any point of starting this yoga? Because now I'm feeling a little bit more pain. But then on the other side of it, if I didn't do the yoga, I would have never discovered this pain until it got really bad down the years, and then I would have suffered more, and getting older, I wouldn't have sorted it. So swings and roundabouts. However, what did we discover? On the screen right now, you'll see my legs are bruised. What we done was we solely focused on a sports massage on my thigh area because that was the area that was causing me the most problem. Now, I don't often bruise. So when the therapist was doing the sports massage, he was proper going for it. And yes, I was feeling a little bit of pain, but not as much pain as I should be feeling. What that sort of told me was my muscles were extremely tight. So the therapist done a couple of tests with me, and I discovered how weak I actually was in the groin area and the quad and hamstring area. The key thing that he told me I had become was number one, experiencing pelvic tilt, and number two, being quad dominant. Now that I've got a label to what the issue is, I was doing some, you know, Googling and YouTube, and if I'd known that earlier, things might have been easier. Now I'm not gonna go into it too much because you open up a different can of worms here. However, what you ultimately are experiencing, pelvic tilt or quad dominance, is where your quads and your thighs and your lower back are doing more work, causing an imbalance because the hamstrings and your abs and your glutes aren't working or are not activated, hence why you get that rounded body shape, like an S shape. You can see the picture on the screen now explaining that. Now, for me personally, I've never heard of quad dominance before, but I wish I had, because now it makes sense. If I'm going to the gym, for example, and I've done a deadlift, basic deadlift, or some of the exercises that should be working quads, should be working glutes or hamstrings, I have not been feeling them. I've been feeling them in my quads and my lower back, meaning that I'm not doing the exercises properly, I've probably got too much weights on, or I didn't know what I was really meant to be working. And that then also reflects in the yoga, because when I started doing research on how to become non-quad dominant, become balanced, and how to activate the glutes, the hamstrings, and the abs, what I realized was all the exercises explained, if you were to isolate those exercises, are the exact same exercises that you do in the DDP yoga program. Which is crazy, because I've been focused on trying to touch my toes and get mobility, but I've not really been focused on what that stretch is actually meant to be working. So for example, glute bridge, that should be activating the glutes. It's in the name, but I haven't really been doing it because I've really been feeling it in my back. So what I need to do now is, when I get into a glute bridge, really squeeze the glutes, the buttocks. When I'm doing the lunges, I've got to make sure that I'm feeling it in the psoas muscle. Psoas muscle, that's a new one I discovered this week as well. But when I'm doing the lunges, I'm feeling it in the right areas. When I'm doing the red hot core workout, I'm making sure that I'm actually working the core. And even the breathing technique, when he tells you to breathe in through the belly button and get the belly button to touch your spine, that's a case of working the deeper muscles in the abs. So as a whole, this week, I've discovered even further where my faults are, but I've also discovered that DDP Yoga will 100% help with correcting those imbalances, but I need to focus on working the right muscles on each pose and really focus on that. And that may well mean I have to step it back a little bit and go back to a modified position, which I don't mind. Now, I put some articles down below if you want to read them about anterior tilt, some exercises as well that you can do. Read it yourself, do your own research. This is my journey, my injuries, my history and my improvement. I'm just hoping this kind of helps yourself as well. So I'm not focused on the weight on the scales at the moment now, because that 11.5 stone target by July is not happening anymore. It was called the unknown fitness journey, weight loss journey, because I didn't know what was gonna happen. And here we are, we're now behind on the yoga program. We've now discovered that I've got further injuries or that I've been doing the exercises wrong. But now we know, now we improve again. It's like being an onion. Layers, people, layers. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you very much for watching this far, and hopefully you've got some nuggets. I think the main takes from this is, if you are starting a program, you know, don't just focus on the weight on the scale. You have to appreciate if your body's telling you you're getting injured, and don't be afraid to go and see somebody to get that extra kind of knowledge or advice, because they may well give you a little nugget which you can then go on Google and research yourself and improve yourself. And that's it for this week. If you did like this video, don't forget to like. And if you want to watch last week's video, press here. And if you want to watch my 60-day review, click here. And don't forget, guys, to subscribe there. And I'll see you next week.